in that whiskey, that's Monica Lewinsky. Molly in that whiskey, that's Monica Lewinsky. Molly in that whiskey, that's Monica Lewinsky.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know I haven't been making videos for a hot minute, but I'm excited to be back today with a humongous book haul from Book Outlet. I mean, look how big this box is. It weighs about 100 pounds. And not only is this going to be a huge and humongous, exciting book haul, but if you watch till the end of the video, you can find out how you can win 3 books from Book Outlet of your choosing. So yes, definitely stay tuned if you're interested to see what I got from Book Outlet and how you can win some free books of your own. So let's get started and open this up. I have some tweezers here to cut the tape with, because you guys know I never have anything normal to open a box with. Like most of my book unboxings, this box has literally been sitting in my room for a month, so I honestly don't remember anything that I got, but I'm very excited to open all of these. So yeah, this is the box. There's a bunch of paper on top. And about a million books inside, so let's get started. Okay, so the first book I'm pulling out here is The 12 Days of Dash and Lily by Rachel Khan and David Levithan. This is actually like a follow-up or a second book to Dash and Lily's Book of Dares, which is a book that came out quite a long time ago by Rachel and David as well. And I really, really love the first book. It's a super cute holiday book about like these two people that fall in love. And I didn't know there was gonna be a second book until last year when I was in the bookstore and I saw that there was a second book. But I saw it on Book Outlet for super cheap, so I decided it would be a good opportunity to grab it so I can maybe read it for this holiday season, because it's definitely like a holiday vibes book, which I love reading books that kind of fit their kind of season, I guess. So that's really exciting. I'm very interested to read this book to see what else they've been up to, these two characters. So let me know if you guys have read this down below or if you've heard anything about it. I'm very excited to read it. Next book that I have here is Georgia Peaches and Other Forbidden Fruit by J. Robin Brown. And I believe that this book is about a girl who is a senior in high school and she is gay and she comes out to her parents, and I think it's her dad that tells her to kind of lay low and not really talk about the fact that she's gay. And so she's kind of like hiding who she really is while going through her senior year of high school and adapting to new changes that are going on in her life. I'm not 100% sure because I just kind of read the synopsis and that's what I'm kind of getting from it. But if any of you guys have read this and have like a better synopsis for what you think goes on in this book, definitely let me know down below. But I'm very intrigued to read this one. I think it's going to be a really awesome book, and I'm excited to read a book with a lesbian main character because I have not read many in my days. But I'm very excited for this one, and it's a really cute cover. So yeah, I'm really excited. Next book that I have here is The Love That Split the World by Emily Henry. I always see this book in Barnes & Noble, but I've never really grabbed it and read the synopsis until I saw it on Book Outlet for super cheap, which I feel like is the start of every book that I talk about from Book Outlet. It's always like, I saw it, so I looked at it finally. But this book, I don't know, it sounds like a love story, but it sounds like there's some other shenanigans that go on where these two main characters are starting to see things differently than they actually appear. So I'm not really sure what kind of genre I would class this in, but I'm excited to read it nonetheless. If any of you guys have read it, let me know, but it sounds interesting. Next book here is The One Real Thing by Samantha Young, and it's the Heart Boardwalk series, which I didn't realize this was a series when I got it, so hopefully it's the first book. Yeah, it says on the back it's the first book, so that's good. I've actually read a book by Samantha Young, I think it was on Dublin Street, and that's kind of like a new adult romance, and I really, really enjoyed it, so I'm super excited to read this one. I'm not 100% sure of the plot, but I kind of trust Samantha Young's writing. I really enjoyed her last book, so I'm excited for this one. I haven't been picking up a ton of new adult books lately, so I'm excited to read this one. Next book I have here is The Season of You and Me by Robin Constantine? Yeah. And this is a young adult book about a girl who's kind of going through a lot in her life. I think her and her boyfriend just broke up, and she's just having all these things go on where she just kind of wants an escape. So she decides to go and live with her father for the summer, who owns this bed and breakfast, and she works there, and I'm gonna guess that she meets a boy there and maybe falls in love. That's kind of what I'm leaning towards with this one, but it sounded super cute, and I love a summery romance book, so I'm excited for this one for the summer, and I hope I get to it soon. Next book I have is sort of a random one that doesn't really fit with everything else I've been showing you so far, but that is Almost Famous Women by Megan Mayhew Bergerman, and this is a book of stories about women in history that were almost famous, that are kind of like in the spotlight but not really, and I guess just kind of some of their stories and things that they've accomplished and things that they've done. And I thought it seemed really interesting and that I'd be interested to read it. And I don't know, I'm excited for this. I love little books that have just kind of singular stories for if I'm not really feeling the need to read a whole novel. I just kind of want to read like a short story. I think this is going to be something I would definitely grab when I'm in one of those moods. So I'm very excited for this one. If any of you guys have read it, definitely let me know because I'm very interested. So the next three books that I bought are actually a trilogy that I decided to pick up because I've literally had my eye on this trilogy for years and years and years. And so many people on BookTube have talked about it. And I feel like BookTube's kind of over it as a whole, but I'm still interested to read it. So that is the Unbecoming of Mara Dyer series. So I have the first book here, and then The Evolution of Mara Dyer, and then The Retribution of Mara Dyer. And I don't know, it seems like a fun book. Not really fun, because I know it follows some really intense and crazy dark stuff, but I thought I'd be interested to maybe pick it up sometime. So I decided to get all three books for a wonderful discounted price. So yeah, let me know if I should read the series. I'm very excited about it, and I'm excited to have all three books in my hands. So that's really cool. So the next book I have is One True Loves by Taylor Jenkins Reid. I believe that this is an adult novel, but I was initially interested in reading it because it takes place in Massachusetts, which is where I live. But it's about this girl who has a husband, I believe. She gets married. They've been married for about a year. And then her husband is on some type of trip and is lost, or he goes away. I don't know what happens. Like, his helicopter goes missing, I guess is what it says, and then he's gone. So she kind of has to live with the fact that her husband is gone, she's no longer with him, and I guess she falls in love with somebody else and gets engaged, and then her husband is found. So I guess one true loves, meaning like she has two people that she loves. I don't know, it sounds really crazy, and I'm kind of interested to read and see what happens, so I'm excited for this one, definitely. Let me know if you've read it. So the next book I have is Austenland by Shannon Hale, and I still haven't exactly wrapped my head around how this book works, but I believe that it is about a character who has a large fascination with like Jane Austen and Pride and Prejudice, but it kind of also has a similar plot to like books by Jane Austen. I'm not really sure, but I thought it sounded really cute and funny, and I'm a huge fan of Jane Austen, so I thought that I would probably enjoy it. So let me know if any of you guys have checked it out, because I'm still not 100% there on what goes on in this book, but I'm excited to read it. Okay, and the last book that I have to share with you guys is completely random, but I wanted it anyway, and that is It's Not Okay by Andy Dwarfman, who is a contestant that was on The Bachelor and then The Bachelorette. And I believe this is kind of about her experience on the show. And I've always had such a fascination with The Bachelor and The Bachelorette shows. So to have kind of like an insider's voice and to hear more about the behind the scenes aspect, I'm actually really excited. And I always really liked Andy when I watched the show. So I'm excited for this book, even if it's kind of weird and random, but I'm excited to read it. Okay guys, so that is it for my book haul, but I'm going to now explain how you can have a chance to win three books of your choosing off of Book Outlet. Super, super simple. The only kind of rules there are is that you should be subscribed to my YouTube channel. You have to be 18 years of age or have your parents' permission. And then you have to be following me on Twitter and Book Outlet on Twitter, because Twitter is kind of where the whole giveaway aspect is happening. So down below in my description box, there should be a link of a tweet about this video. So it's probably something like, go check out Lovely Like Lara's new video and retweet to win three books of your choosing. All you have to do is go retweet that on Twitter, follow both of us on Twitter, and then you are entered for a chance to win. And then Book Outlet is going to randomly choose one of the people that retweeted it, and they will be chosen to win three books of their choosing, and Book Outlet will send them to you. So yeah, you have to be following them so that they can contact you via DMs, and then follow me and subscribe to my channel. That's really all. I'll have right here how long the giveaway will be open for, because I'm not sure off the top of my head. But yeah, that's really exciting. So if you want a chance to win some books off of Book Outlet, maybe some of these ones, definitely look down below. Also down below linked is my Book Outlet vlogger page, which some of you guys know I am a Book Outlet vlogger friend. So I have a whole page on their website displaying all of the past books that I've purchased and shown in hauls. So if there's any books in this haul or any of my previous Book Outlet hauls that you're interested in, definitely go check out my page, because you'll easily be able to get to the books and everything and check them out. So definitely go look at that if you're interested. Other than that, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below telling me which book you think is the most interesting, which books I should start first, anything like that. But I hope you guys are having an absolutely wonderful day. Make sure to go enter the giveaway, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye! That's Monica Lewinsky. Work. Monica. Monica Lewinsky.